exit that is closest to you. So we're just waiting for the graduates to come. We can have an interlude of music, please. Okay. I understand that the graduates are ready to come. So to begin our celebration, kindly let us all arise and welcome the class of 2021 graduates in the following programs. So the first one is the Kenya Registered Nursing. Let us give them a round of applause. Nursing. Let's appreciate them. Thank you. Let us welcome the faculty and administrative staff of the Cicely MacDonnell College of Health Sciences. Upstanding, let us, we are going to sing the national anthem, and it shall be followed by the East African national anthem, and we shall remain standing even as we have the opening prayer. The national anthem, please.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, the creator of the universe and the giver of all things to humanity, we come before you this afternoon. We humble ourselves and we surrender ourselves all this activity of this day. All that we have achieved today is out of your grace. We ask you, Almighty Father, thank you for the gift of our courage. Thank you for the gift of the teachers and the administration who have contributed, who have united themselves to support those who wanted to learn and their ability this day. The joy in our hearts, we want to express all that we are going to do.
That is, Jesus Christ, we need your protection, we need your care, and we need your provider. Whatever we need, we send that to you. All those guests of the day, we ask Almighty Father, they are your children. You created them in your own image, and they come before you to give you thanks. What you have worked tirelessly, despite all the challenges of all these years they have been looking for, Jesus Christ, you have given them. We ask you that whatever we say, we ask you whatever we do according to your will. Where we have gone wrong, don't look upon our weakness and our sins, but look upon the faith which has made us to stand before you to give you thanks. We ask this and believe in Jesus' name, we pray.
Thank you. You may now be seated. Our distinguished guests, our chief guest this afternoon is the National Director of the World Vision in Kenya, Ms. Lilian Dodzo. We have the presence of our board member, Mr. Philemon Moisaka. We have our Chief Executive Officer, the Nairobi Hospital, Mr. James Nyamongo. We have Mr. Jared Osoro, Director, Credit Markets, FSDA. We also do have in our midst the Acting Director, Nursing Services, Scholar Kisia. We have the Acting Principal, College of Health Sciences, Mrs. Mbeda. We also do have the NAC Chairperson, Mr. Collins. We have the faculty of the Cicely McDonnell College of Health Sciences. We also have members of the senior management team, the heads of departments, the unit managers, charge nurses, nurse preceptors, and team leaders. We also have staff of the Nairobi Hospital, our graduates, and our invited guests. So it gives me great pleasure to welcome you all to the 27th graduation ceremony of the Cicely McDonnell College of Health Sciences. And this is the second time we are holding a hybrid graduation, which is both face-to-face, and we have a number of people following us virtually. We are also honored to have parents, guardians, siblings, spouses, and friends of the graduates joining us. I also recognize that we have our friends from AMREF, Catherine and Jerry, and we also have members from Kenyatta National Hospital, NAC committee. So before we begin, I also do have a number of announcements. We are still having COVID-19 with us, so we are requesting that we observe the COVID-19 guidelines provided by the government to prevent transmission of the SARS-CoV-2 virus. And this includes wearing your face mask at all times, properly covering your nose and mouth, maintaining social distance from one another, at least have one seat between you and the next person, practicing hand washing or sanitizing, and therefore that will help us to keep this infection at bay. We also want to announce that there are a number of social media connections. We have hashtag is 27 graduation ceremony or training in uncertain times. The Twitter handle is at the Nairobi Hospital. On Facebook, we are the Nairobi Hospital, and on YouTube, the Nairobi Hospital. So I'll be calling on later my co-MC, Mr. Obare, to read the messages to the graduates. Now I will invite the acting principal of the Cicely McDonnell College of Health Sciences, Mrs. Joyce Mbeda, to make the opening remarks.
Our chief guest this afternoon, Ms. Lilian Dozo, board member, Mr. Philemon Moisaka, our CEO, Mr. James Nyamongo, our invited guest, Mr. Jared Osoro, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, all protocols observed, good afternoon. Good afternoon. Madam Chief Guest, on behalf of my faculty and the administrative staff of the Cicely McDonnell School of Nursing and the whole College of Health Science fraternity, including the students, that includes my students, I take this opportunity to congratulate the graduates who are assembled here today. Your graduation is a culmination of hard work, very hard work, great determination, and perseverance. You did, and we know you did, face a lot of challenges during your 1 year for those who are doing post-basic nursing and 3 years for the Kenya registered nurses. You did endure a lot of work and pain and sleepless nights. But we thank God that you have made it. We thank God that we are here today to celebrate that hard work. Now, apart from the academic accomplishments that we celebrate today, there are other useful lessons that we learned. We also know that you acquired many skills from the Cicely McDonnell School of Nursing. But most importantly, what you learned from the TNH, from the Nairobi Hospital. You learned about the culture, the TNH culture, so that wherever you will go, for those who don't, who trained here but belong to other institutions, you know, we know that you are our ambassadors. You learned the culture, and that culture of great, of hard work, that culture of looking for excellence and quality, and we were proud to impart that. We were also very, very specific about excellence, and you learned that. And we take a lot of pride as an institution in our reputation, in the provision of high standards. And you ensured that we maintained that high standard, and we are very proud of you for doing that. You also learned, among other things, and you learned and assimilated the TNH values, which includes values such as dedication to your work. And we saw that. You learned the value of empathy, which is one that we hold dear to our heart as the TNH fraternity. You also learned the values of inspiration, to inspire those who are coming behind you and those that you are working with, and we saw that. You also embraced the value of quality and partnership, and for that, we are really proud of you. So these ingredients are those that will not only make you successful, professionals wherever you will go, but it will make you successful people in whichever society that you will join. Madam Chief Guest, today represents the most important hallmark in our academic year. It marks the achievement of our key goal as a leading college to provide quality education, training, as well as research and innovation of services to humanity. On this occasion of our 27th graduation ceremony, I wish to acknowledge the efforts of the KHA board under the leadership of the chair, the chairman of the board, Dr. Irungu, who is ably represented this afternoon by his vice chair. We also want to recognize the hospital management and staff for what they have done for our graduates under the leadership of our CEO, Mr. Nyamongo. We want to recognize the efforts and the hard work of the faculty, the administrative staff, and the entire student body for the solid contributions that they made towards propelling these graduates to where they are today. I also acknowledge the very, very vital role that is played by our partners, and chief among them would be the Kenyatta National Hospital that allows us to train our students with them. We also want to recognize institutions such as Mathare Teaching and Referral Hospital. We want to recognize institutions such as the county health facilities where we take our students, and those are some of the partnership. We also want to and appreciate the role of the Nursing Council of Kenya that they have played in steering our students to where they are today. We also have other partners who are ably represented, and we shall name them one by one. We don't want to forget institutions such as Daystar Next Door, whom we partner with very ably in helping their students, and they're helping ours as well. It wouldn't be appropriate to really at this moment mention our sponsors and those who make it possible for our students who are to be able to achieve their goal. We have sponsors such as the Johnson & Johnson through AMREF Africa that sponsored a section of these students so that they were able to realize their dream of becoming oncology nurses. We also have a body known as Lending for Education African Project that also facilitated the learning of many of these students by sponsoring them and ensuring that there was fee, their tuition fee and their other boarding fees and their other upkeep was maintained. So we really do want to mention them. We also want to take at this point, Madam Chief Guest, we know that the Cicely McDonald College of Health Sciences, both internationally and locally, we have continued to be recognized. And it's evidenced by the way our graduates are sought after, both locally and internationally, and especially in the healthcare industry, but also in other institutions. The college has made great achievements and in academic performance, and is recognized as a leading institution, as I said, locally and internationally, in training high-caliber nurses, and that we can attest to. Training high-caliber nurses to provide excellent patient care that they do and they continue to do. Now, as we celebrate this day, Madam Chief Guest, I am pleased to report that we shall be awarding 90 graduates this afternoon who successfully passed their examinations, their licensing examinations, with diplomas in registered nursing and specialized diplomas. So out of the 90, 49, a section of them, 49, are registered nurses and 41 are different categories of specialized nurses, as we will see as we go along. Now, we at the Cicely McDonald College of Health Sciences will continue to do our best to ensure that we graduate competent and skillful nurses whose qualifications are above board and are easily absorbed wherever they go, because they are able to not only adapt to the ever-changing global health market, but they're able to adapt to every situation, and therefore they are ready for the job market out there and within the institution. We will settle for nothing but the best, and that is something that we attest to. As a measure of our commitment to maintain continually improve quality of success of service and products, we are currently improving our processes and our strategies to achieve even better results as we go along. So as we continue to improve our standards and footing as a leading college in nursing, let me also stress once more, Madam Chief Guest, that our core business of any, which is the core business of any respectable health training institution, is education, training, research, and innovation, something that we have embraced very dearly and close to us. So allow me to also offer a few words of advice to our graduates this afternoon. So as you go out there, this is just the beginning. It's just a milestone in your professional life. As you go out there, we want you to not only be comfortable with the certificate or the diploma that you will receive this afternoon, for you to be able to remain critical and relevant in your chosen profession, you will need to keep learning. We don't want you to stay and stick in the periphery. You will need to keep learning. So we have ensured that we, as the Cicely McDonald, we ensure that you have what it takes. We have what it takes, not just a firm foothold in your chosen career, but also requisite dynamism, creativity, and entrepreneurial spirit to adapt to this rapidly changing environment and to remain useful and to remain relevant. Let your arguments, your ideals, your convictions, your practices always depict you as an enlightened, an honest, a balanced participant in the positive events around you. Do not allow yourself to be reduced to mere spectators in the profession, because we know that we have prepared you to be anything but that. Do not engage in any demeaning undertakings, and above all, be true to the tenets of the nursing profession, which includes integrity, passion, dignity, and commitment as envisaged in the Nursing Code of Ethics. And finally, Madam Chief Guest, I take this opportunity to wish every one of you here a happy and prosperous 2022. Thank you, and may God bless you all.
Round of applause. Thank you. Thank you very much, Mrs. Mbetha. I would like to recognize the presence of the Vice Chair of the Board, Honorable Dr. Chris Bichage, and the Registrar of the Nursing Council, Mrs. Edna Talam Kimayo. You're most welcome. It now gives me great pleasure to invite the Chief Executive Officer of the Nairobi Hospital, Mr. James Nyamongo, to make his remarks, and thereafter invite the Vice Chairman of the Kenya Hospital Board of Management, who will in turn invite our chief guest to address the gathering. Mr. Nyamongo, please speak to us.
Good afternoon, the chief guest, Ms. Lillian Doso, National Director of World Vision, Kenya, the Chairman, Board of Management, Kenya Association, who is ably represented here by the Vice Chair, Dr. Chris Bichage, KHA member, board members, the Medical Advisory Committee members who are present, members of that meeting, staff association, staff of the Nairobi Hospital, and the Cicely McDonald College of Health Sciences. Graduates, parents and guardians, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, this afternoon we are all assembled here to witness this great occasion, and this is my second function of graduation I'm attending here since I joined the hospital, which is about 12 months, maybe 1 week for me to finish 1 year. This afternoon, I'm delighted to welcome you all to celebrate with us the achievement of our 27th graduation cohort of students. This is a special day in our calendar of events. We are particularly delighted that we can hold this ceremony as the wave of COVID-19 pandemic has subsided. I extend my heartfelt appreciation to all of you for finding time to participate in this auspicious occasion, and to the organizers for hosting us here today. As we congratulate the graduates, let us take a moment to reflect on the world in which they will be offering their services. The greatest challenge of our time is how to navigate the changes that the COVID pandemic has imposed on our work and livelihoods. It has taught us in a rather brutal way that we must adapt to the emerging global environment that is shaping our future. The world of work has changed dramatically. So have many other aspects of our lives, including how we socialize, how to celebrate life, and rules of it, how we worship, how we travel, and how we live. Our relevance arising from these events is how we deliver our teachings and training programs. This graduating class is a living example of our ability to adapt to the new normal environment and embrace change. Our college has delivered a quality knowledge on virtual platforms, minimizing disruptions that could otherwise have delayed the progression of our students. And this is something probably would say that we are proud of as an institution, that we have offered this particular facility or embraced the new technology which has enabled these graduates to be here. Otherwise, we could have probably gone back 1 year, but we managed to overcome those challenges, and now we are having all these 90 graduates to graduate today. This graduates class is a living example of the ability to adopt the new normal, as you have said. Our chief guest today, I assure you that I'm particularly proud of the College of Health Sciences for every managing this transition. The individual and the collective efforts of the management, staff, and ensured our students received quality education without disruption. They also supported the college and the students to adopt to the new learning environment driven by digital technology. This enabled the college to realize its vision, that is, to be a center of excellence in healthcare training in the region, providing world-class professional nursing education and services. To you graduates, you made us proud by quickly embracing the digital shift and taking online classes to complete your studies. You have successfully worked together to the end of your long academic journey. We celebrate you for overcoming the challenges that you experienced and focusing on the opportunities ahead of you to serve humanity. I encourage you to practice what you have learned by providing safe nursing care to your patients wherever you serve in this world. You have an opportunity to contribute to sustainable health care for Kenyans and the rest of the world. And by this, probably, I will be the first beneficiary of these graduates, because I know I'm going to retain a number of you here as you leave this place. So probably, as you also serve other places, for those who will find opportunity, this will be a better place for you. And I think you have realized that, as Madam Principal said, that this institution trains credible and highly qualified staff who can serve humanity anywhere in the world. And this one is something which probably we have witnessed since I came here. I've seen quite a number of exodus moving from this institution, especially the new graduates, and more so on the specialized area. We will continue supporting those specialized areas, and I'm happy proud to announce that our institution, especially the College of Health Sciences, we are calling out some various restructuring which is going to be beneficial to other students who are going to come. We will find the place to be more providing specialized training. We appreciate those who have worked with us in this channel, and I wish to thank our partners most sincerely for ensuring our students can afford quality education at our prestigious college. Special thanks goes to AmLab Health Africa, Johnson & Johnson, who have partnered with us by sponsoring 9 oncology nursing students who are graduating today. I also wish to recognize the Lending for Education in Africa Partnership Program, who are providing educational loans to more than 20 students. This one, we take a lot of pride to thank our partners, and we'll be looking forward in the near future to open our doors to more partners to come and join us, especially at this time now whereby most of our students, we have been finding that they are dropping out of school. And maybe, Mr. Chairman, as we talk here, we remember what we have been discussing at our board level, whereby we have in pursuing areas which we can probably discover more funding for our young ones to come and join and maybe benefit from this educational facility from here to enable provide these services, needed services. And we are also looking forward to partner with our county government, especially to benefit from the specialist training like oncology and other areas. These are areas which we are looking forward for more partnership, and we'll be discussing in the near future to see how best these opportunities can be found and be sustained. We are open to other partnership, as I've said, that will give potential students access to quality nursing education in our college. We don't want to leave them behind. We want to look forward and see that they have achieved their dreams. And as I said earlier in that forum, that we as an institution, we need to encourage especially those students from the remote areas and rural areas who are aspiring. And Madam Chair, I will ask especially your institution, our chief guest, which is really looking to support most of the programs in semi-arid and semi-arid areas, if you can probably partner with us and support one or two students, especially those who are very much interested, especially to be nurses, to be just by the call that they want to be nurses. These are areas which you maybe, as you leave this place, we would like to leave as an homework for you to be thinking and see how best we can support us in this area. I leave you with the wise words of the late Maya Angelou, an American poet and civil rights activist, who said, if you are always trying to be normal, you will never know how amazing you can be. Our chief guest this afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, allow me now to invite the chairman of the Board of Management, who is presented here by our vice chairman, to address this assembly. Thank you, and God bless you all.
Thank you so much, Bwana CEO James Nyamongo. And I'm very excited that I'm attending the second graduation ceremony for the School of Nursing. Madam Guest of Honor, I have to pronounce your name well, Dozo. Is that correct? Thank you, Madam Lillian Dozo. Now, board members present, I can see my brother, Commissioner Philemon Mwisaka, board members of the Kenya Hospital Association, Medical Advisory Council, CEO Bwana James Nyamongo, the senior management team present, Principal Cecil McDonald, College of Nursing and Health Sciences, staff of the Nairobi Hospital and the College Health Sciences, graduates who are our main focus today, parents, guardians, and distinguished guests. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Good afternoon, all of you. I'm delighted to convey to you my warm greetings and those of the entire Board of Management of the Kenya Hospital Association. We are greatly honored by your presence today. Now, it is my singular pleasure to welcome you to the 27th graduation convocation of the Cecil McDonald College of Health Sciences. Our deepest appreciation to the chief guest, Madam Lillian Dozo, for honoring our invitation to officiate at this auspicious occasion. Let me congratulate the 90 graduates who, through hard work and determination, have successfully completed their nursing training. You are ready to go into the world to serve humanity. This year's graduation theme, Training in Uncertain Times, underscores our commitment to embrace innovation in nursing education in times of adversity and disruption. You can all agree that this is very, very current with all these COVID-19 challenges. The board has continued to support the college with particular focus on strengthening its academic programs and infrastructure development. Our students are assured of quality training that enables them to graduate with internationally recognized knowledge skills. They can work in any part of the world. The students graduating today have an enviable opportunity to join a global healthcare community of service that is at the front line of the world's fight against disease, including the COVID-19 pandemic. The board acknowledges the significant strides that the college continues to make in providing nursing education and responding to the growing national and global demand for nursing care expertise. The college has a reputation for producing highly competent registered nurses and specialized nurses in critical care, perioperative accident and emergency, and neonatal nursing. These are specialized areas. In September 2020, the college commenced training in oncology nursing, responding to the increasing burden of cancer globally. We shall witness the first cohort of oncology nursing graduating here today. We can clap for them, these ones who are coming. Furthermore, the college will soon be offering another specialized training in nephrology nursing. George Soros, a renowned author and speaker on innovation, teaching, learning, and leadership, once said, "Technology will never replace great teachers, but technology in the hands of great teachers can be transformational." In this regard, the board's commitment is to empower the faculty to access the necessary resources to deliver quality teaching. This will enable the college to introduce additional academic programs to meet the growing demand for nursing care education. I sincerely thank the faculty, the parents, guardians, and sponsors for supporting the graduates to pursue their studies to completion. To the graduates, former South African President Nelson Mandela described education as the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. We have armed you with the knowledge and the skills to change the world, to make it a better place for our present and future generations. I encourage you to be good ambassadors of this college and the TNH family. Wherever you go, you will contribute to our brand reputation by offering quality nursing with a smile. My hearty congratulations to you all for your achievements. I wish you all the best and God's graces in your future endeavors. To our stakeholders and partners, we appreciate you for enabling our students to access quality healthcare, knowledge, and skills. You have contributed to better quality healthcare services in Kenya and wherever in this world that our nurses offer their services. Thank you, and God bless you. Now, this is my boss's speech. It's not mine, I'm just a microphone. But I want to add that you may have realized I walked in a little bit late. I apologize for that, but very interesting is that I had gone to pick my brother's daughter, who is a nurse in the United States of America. She's a senior nurse. And I dropped her home and I told her, "I'm not going to talk to you because I'm already very late." And I came here, but she told me one thing, that in America now, and basically in the West, they are fishing for nurses in Kenya, and more particularly, because she knows I'm the vice chairman of the Nairobi Hospital, we very critically want to pick nurses from then Nairobi Hospital. And I told her, wait a minute. You are my guest. You are not coming here to poach. There is no nurse you are getting from Nairobi Hospital, and you can take that to the bank. Why am I saying that? Because home is always best. And I can assure you that my chairman and your board are going to do what I've had the CEO say here today, that we are aggressively trying to improve terms and conditions of service for nurses, more specifically clinical nurses. And I can assure you that if you have any rumors, before we came to this board, there were a bit of grumblings. But today, Madam Principal, am I not right that the rumors are things are getting better, better, and more better? I can assure you that those of you who will be lucky to be retained by the CEO are going to be a bit excited. Because I've traveled internationally, and I can assure you that everywhere sounds rosy, but home is always best. And I can let you know that as I now round up, you are in a very privileged position. The beauty that you've come out as a qualified nurse, this country is a wonderful opportunity, and the things going forward are going on to be rosy, and I can assure you that the board of management, under the chairmanship of our brother, Dr. Wilfred Irungu Dirangu, and everybody under him, including the staff, are doing our best to give you a good working environment so that our stakeholders, more particularly the patient, are going out of this hospital saying, we had an experience, not we had a problem. So congratulations, and with those few remarks, it's now my pleasure to let you know that I am going to bring our guest of honor to talk to you and give you wisdom, but I can assure you that this is somebody who has seen the world. It's not an ordinary person. Madam Rida Ndoso very soon will have the title Dr. Lillian Ndoso, Permanent Edge Damage, which they call a PhD, very, very soon. Madam is the Program Manager, Humanitarian Operations, Communications and Advocacy. That's our profession. Our work experience has been wide. Lillian has over 15 years' experience in international development planning. She has extensive experience in Africa, having worked as the National Director for World Vision in Sierra Leone, Mali, and Mauritania. She has served in World Vision Kenya, I believe, for 11 years in different capacities. Lillian joined World Vision Kenya on October 2019 as the National Director and Chair of the Senior Leadership Team. She sits in the Governance and Nomination Committee of the World Vision Kenya Executive Board, as well as the National Resource Development, Finance and Supply Chain Committees as the management lead. National Development, Finance and Supply Chain as the management lead. She also serves as a board member of Vision Fund Kenya, which is World Vision's microfinance agency. Lillian holds an MBA and is currently undertaking a PhD studies in leadership at Anderson University, the USA. Our PhD studies are focused on our interest in understanding the complexities and challenges of leading change within organizations with the purpose of leading and creating transformative organizations and communities. This interdisciplinary program is providing Lillian with opportunities to engage in scholarship and research to develop professional competencies related to organizational leadership, leadership strategies, analyzing organizational culture, team and workplace culture development, leading organizational change, and responding to workplace and career dynamics in increasingly technological and global society, amongst other leadership skills. Lillian is a Christian who professes the life of Christ, a Zimbabwean by birth, a mother, a sister, and a friend to many. She has a passion for Africa to contribute towards empowering and uplifting women, children, and marginal communities so that they enjoy life in all its fullness. Wow, what a CV. Now, Madam Principal and Bwana CEO, you couldn't have had a more fitting guest of honor for this function than Lillian. I am encouraged that after this forum, I will not hurry to separate with her because I would like to borrow a bit of brains from Lillian as our nurses celebrate their achievement. Now, it's my singular duty, pleasant, to invite my sister Lillian to come here and kindly, can we have a loud applause? Stand up. Thank you so much, my sister, and welcome.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you,
sir.
Please be seated. Thank you. Wow, what a wonderful presentation and introduction. Thank you so much, Honorable Dr. Chris Bijage. Let me start by acknowledging our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and just say, Ebenezer, that's far the Lord has brought us. And today is the day that the Lord has made. So let's all rejoice and be glad in it. Congratulations to you all. Chairman of the Board of Management, Dr. Irungu Ndirangu, represented by Vice Chairman of the Board of Management, Honorable Dr. Chris Bichage, board members here present, the Chief Executive Officer, the Principal College of Health Sciences, invited guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to preside over this auspicious 27th graduation ceremony, which marks a very important checkpoint in your calendar. And secondly, to our graduating class for the commencement of your professional lives after completing your nursing and specialist diplomas. Congratulations to you all. I wish to take this opportunity to congratulate you all. This is indeed a great achievement, which could not have been realized without hard work, without dedication, without focus, and without commitment. And as Honorable Dr. Chris has said, education is a lifelong experience. So I hope by graduating today, you are not going to stop here. You will continue to push barriers, push yourselves to really exceed expectations and go out there and change the world. Allow me to also commend the entire teaching staff in the College of Health Sciences, parents, as well as guardians, and the entire national hospital community as a whole for providing the necessary training and enabling environment for learning. The excellent performance that we are witnessing today by the graduate is evident because of this team effort. To the graduates, today is an important milestone in your lives because it marks the beginning of a new era as professional nurses. You have begun the process of growing and learning in the profession, which is built on the principles of caring and treating patients and their families with dignity, with humanity, and also by understanding their individual needs, showing compassion, sensitivity, responsiveness, and providing care in a way that respects all people equally. You know, as I was being introduced, you've heard that I often work with marginalized and poor communities. But these are people that also require care, and they require that care with the dignity that they deserve, with the respect that they deserve. And this is what you are called upon to do as you graduate today. And over the years, nursing has gained professional and public recognition as a health science of caring. And this is a virtue, ladies and gentlemen, that are graduating today, that you need to perpetuate. As professional nurses, your approach to your career is important, and you should strive for excellence, control, and maintenance of high standards and practice. And my call to you today is, as you go out there, know and keep in your hearts that you are working for God and not for men. And what our God asks for, what our God demands of us, is excellence. You are expected to embrace ethical values, responsibility, accountability, and work closely within teams and other professionals while making sure patient care and treatment is coordinated and is of high standards. I've also heard that you've received your training in uncertain times, because we all know that the environment that we are currently operating in is very volatile and very uncertain. Since the beginning of March 2020, the COVID-19 pandemic has not spared nurses. It has impacted nurses and the field of nursing profoundly in terms of direct care capabilities, in terms of nursing practice issues, healthcare system operations. And importantly, the pandemic has influenced strongly the professional identity of nurses and nursing education. Nurses became the face of healthcare during the pandemic, and I dare say they still are, and they still will be, even as we hear of various variants of the COVID-19 pandemic that are emerging. I'm informed that you had to take a huge portion of your training virtually, a first of its kind. This shows that even as you graduate, you must know that you are going into a world where you need to be agile, where you need to adapt to the changing context, because that is the kind of volatile and uncertain world in which we are all now working. And it's my hope that through this adaptation, you have developed resilience in handling volatile and uncertain times that may come your way in your future practice. The consumers of healthcare are better informed, and they demand their rights. The patients demand and deserve assurance of patient-centered, individual, and high-quality nursing care from the nurse. The nursing profession is evolving rapidly to meet the patient needs, challenges, and opportunities presented by the constant technology-driven changes. This has necessitated evidence-based nursing interventions to guarantee quality of care. And what do these changes mean? Nurses are a force to be reckoned with. And I suggest that this is more prominent now, more than ever before. The challenges encountered by nurses are stepping stones to realize the breadth of opportunities within nursing and the new confidence that nurses have. We've just heard from the Vice Chair how there's a growing demand for Kenyan nurses, so the breadth of opportunities are endless. Nurses are now working in multidisciplinary teams and are encouraged to speak up, ask questions, and play a bigger part in the team more than ever before, as well as make significant contributions in patients' care. We also have opportunities for specialized roles in nursing, such as oncology. I hear we've got some of our colleagues who are graduating today as oncology nurses, critical care, perioperative care, emergency care, nephrology, and wound care, among many others. Now, as an international development worker myself, I would not miss this opportunity to address you without also trying to entice you, just as Dr. Chris was trying to do to entice you to stay. I'm also going to entice you to consider joining the humanitarian as well as the development world of nursing. Know that there are also opportunities for qualified nurses in the development and humanitarian space in which I work and in which World Vision Kenya operates, because there too we grapple with issues related to maternal and child health, related to child nutrition. We also deal with issues like the health pandemic, amongst others. We also work with various healthcare facilities across the country as we seek to ensure the well-being of children. And we already are working with some amazing, well-trained nurses who have dedicated their lives to end health inequalities across Kenya. This shows you that the nursing profession has become so varied and so critical, touching many communities and individuals, while nursing staff are widely trusted by the public. This unique position that you have shows how special you all are for responding to this nursing calling, and allows nursing staff to deliver better health outcomes and wider social change, key goals of the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. In 2015, ladies and gentlemen, the United Nations member states agreed to 17 Sustainable Development Goals, and Kenya is a member of those United Nations member states. These included ending poverty and hunger, good health and education for all, access to clean water and sanitation, empowering women and girls, economic growth, and combating climate change by 2030. Combined, all these factors affect health outcomes. That is why I say nurses are important to international development. We have seen how nurses have been at the forefront of battling the public health crisis the world continues to face, which is the COVID-19 pandemic. This has destroyed lives and it has eroded economic livelihoods, rendering many Kenyans completely vulnerable and dependent on aid. Nurses have also been at the battlefront of dealing with mental health issues that populations have faced, including children, among whom have been hundreds of thousands of female school children who fell pregnant when schools were closed due to COVID-19 lockdowns. As World Vision Kenya, we've been working with nurses and other healthcare professionals, including community health volunteers, to identify and address this pandemic, as well as addressing systematic and cultural issues that contribute towards the health inequalities experienced by the poor and vulnerable communities and families in Kenya, especially children. In conclusion, as you go to the world as professionals, remember that nursing is at the core of healthcare systems, globally contributing to achievement of high quality, accessible and affordable healthcare. Through their scientific reasoning and proximity to the patient, nurses are nursing the entire world to health. Nurses form the largest group of frontline health professionals, providing healthcare to individuals and communities. They have powerful stories to tell that can help to bring about positive change in humanity. And this challenge, ladies and gentlemen, is upon you, our graduates, as you take the Florence Nightingale oath to serve humanity. And before I end my speech, I want to take on the challenge that was presented to World Vision Kenya by your principal, that we will indeed work in partnership with this college to make sure that we also sponsor a few students to make sure that they contribute to the health sector. So I wish you well as you begin your nursing journey at the various stages, And once again, congratulations and God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, our chief guest. Let us appreciate our chief guest once more. Thank you. At this point in time, our chief guest, please allow me to read congratulatory messages from our online audience. As you can be able to see, ours is an international graduation ceremony. We have various representatives among us, starting from our chief guest. She's an international guest all the way from Zimbabwe. Our vice chairman of the board has just alerted us that he had gone to pick a guest from the US. And so from our online audience, we have the following, appreciate the graduates. Top on the list, we have Wilfred Nyambariga, who congratulates Omoyo Lydia. Thanks to God for seeing you this far. We have Hilary Mahasi, Sylvester Kibet, and Mercy Arua. Congratulations to all the graduates. We have Anne Kamuyu to Christine Kamuyu. Congratulations. God bless you. Then from Lucy Kabi to Beatrice. Congratulations, my dear daughter. Enoch Anyika to Yoz Kavira. Congratulations. Esther Njogu to Joseph Nguyo. Congratulations, my loving son. You have made it. Nelly Munene to Yvonne Wamboi. Congratulations, my dear. Then on Facebook, we have Flora Nderitu to Neema Givaiga. Congratulations. Naomi Kumu to Joy Mudhama. You have done your mama proud. I love you. Then we have one of our international lecturers, Mr. Judy Mulandi, who takes this opportunity to congratulate all the graduates, especially to oncology nursing graduates. I'm so happy and proud of you. We give God all the glory. Josepha Tumange, congratulations to Melissa Asiko and Sarah, the new Kenya registered critical care nurses. Robert Ekiru to Lydia Omoyo. Then we have one of our renowned nurses, Nelias Ndirangu, who congratulates the following. Valentine Lanek, Dora, Amina Ogle, and Miwi, congratulations, you made me proud, and I'm waiting for you in the clinical placement. Lilian Alukwe, congratulations to all the graduates and to my friend, Shivoko. Then lastly, we have Julia Esili. Congratulations to Nairobi, Cicely McDonough College of Health Sciences. We are very proud of you. And lastly, congratulations to Nicholas. We are waiting for you to nurse us. Nicholas, just in case Nairobi Hospital does not give you an opportunity, already you have an opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Barre. So our chief guest, please allow me to welcome the Deputy Principal Post Basic Programs, Ms. Immaculate Ombugu, to preside over the next session, which is the awarding of diplomas and specialist diplomas. Thank you.
Thank you, Sarah. So our chief guests, all protocols observed, allow me to present the following 90 graduates who have satisfied the faculty of College of Health Sciences and have qualified to be awarded the various diplomas in the areas of study. So the graduates, I request you to stand once I call your name and remain standing until the diploma is awarded. So we are going to start with the Kenya Registered Nursing. So Kenya Registered Nursing, September 2017 class. Akoth Knight Valerie. Shege Kaminwa Kevin. Gubal Ali Tura. Kamuyu Wanjiru Christine, Kanani Nairesiai Ruth, Kanja Waithera Diana, Karanja Wangui Diana, Karungari Suzette, Havira Yop Yose, Kilemi Kanana Anita, Kipkoboi Dora, Lanek Rivaso Valentine, Losem Chepkemoi Naomi, Masharia Wamuyu Beatrice, Migwi Nyawira Joyce, Mubi Sisley, Murathi Wajiro Jane, Muthama Wagari Joy, Mutua Kaluki Matilda, Guyo Murioki Joseph, Ogle Ahmed Amina, Okwako Derek Nicholas, Omoyo Jerubo Lydia, Sang Jepkoskei Winnie, Wambua Mulewa Lynn, Wekunda Christabel, and in absentia we have Mwake Kilud Francis, Sawo Awor Fiona, and Soita Nagila Laventa. So chief guest, I request you to award the diploma in Kenya Registered Nursing.
Thank you. As I've been requested to do, I hereby award you a diploma in Kenya Registered Nursing in recognition of your education, training, and successful completion of this course. Congratulations.
Thank you, Chief Guest. You may be seated. So the next group is April 2018 class. Chimoli Shivoka Bibiana, Karwana Wangai Job, Kibutu Nyokabi Nicole, Kimani Wajiru Ann, Masharia Nyambura Lona, Masakari Nasimiu Patricia, Matara Atura Peter, Musembi Mthenya Betty, Dithi Wamboi Sylvia, Gonyo Kuvuna Joyce, Gugi Bola Luna, Jiri Wanjiro Grace, Nyabane Areri Wycliffe, Ogonyo Kerubo Zilla, Okoth Were Harriet, Osieko Wangari Alice, Wanjala Nafula Isabel, Wesonga Namuswa Sydney, Yaya Joy Miriam, and Zamzam Hussein Osman.
Thank you. I hereby award you a diploma in Kenya Registered Nursing in recognition of your education, training, and successful completion of this course. Congratulations to you all.
Thank you. You may be seated. So chief guest, now we are going to the higher diploma awards. These are the one-year program specialist nurses. And we'll start with the Kenya Registered Critical Care Nurses. Ayeko Ogedo Blasto, Gitari Gatwiri Maureen, Karanja Muthoni Naomi, Karioki Wamboi Yvonne, Kavoi Pendo Lucy, Maina Kiare Peter, Maina Wajiru Monica in absentia, Biriri Dungu John, Miruka Nyaosi Caleb, Murethi Munene Steve, Murungi Gasheri Masi, Murungi Muika Juliano, Mwaneki Nyaga Salesio, Maura Ngedo Damaris, Nyabde Otieno Sara, Nyoike Wangari Ann, Oirere Bina Emelda, Olwete Asiko Melissa, Onyinkwa Mora Yukabeth, Otudo Damaris, Wangoi Masi, and Waweru Gikaru David.
I hereby award you a diploma in Kenya Registered Critical Care Nursing in recognition of your education, training, and successful completion of this course. Congratulations to you all.
Thank you so much. You may be seated. All right, so now we go to the Kenya Registered Neonatal Critical Care Nursing, September 2019 class. Fancy Chelangat, Chepkemoi Joyce, Gero Mora Emily, Githaiga Wanja Grace, Karanja Wajiku Lucy, Lagat Kiplimo Erastus, Maina Watiri Susan, Mudabi Kahombi Masi, Jumbi Wamboi Ann, and Warui Jerry Winnie.
I hereby award you a diploma in Kenya Registered Neonatal Critical Care Nursing in recognition of your education, training, and successful completion of this course. Congratulations to you all.
Thank you. So to our last group, this is the pioneer class of the Kenya Registered Oncology Nursing. Gisheha Jerry Rosbell, Machuki Nyamoya Edwin, Malea Kivali Leonida, Murage Wanjiro Tabitha, Mwangi Waboi Judy, Mwaniki Patience, Mwenda Muguna Nicholas, Nyakundi Kwamboka Veronica, and Maina Gitari Isaac in absentia.
I hereby award you a diploma in Kenya Registered Oncology Nursing in recognition of your education, training, and successful completion of this course. Congratulations to you all.
Thank you so much, Chief Guest, and congratulations. Now you are graduates, you are no longer graduates. So now we change to graduates. Congratulations to you all. We can all appreciate them. So thank you so much, our Chief Guest, for awarding the different diplomas. So now we go to the next section where we recognize those that have great achievements. All of us did very well, but there are those that did extremely well, and so we are going to have different recognitions. So we will start from the College of Health Sciences Awards, the Nairobi Hospital College of Health Sciences Awards, and for this I request our Chief Guest, accompanied by the Vice Chair and our CEO, assisted by Mrs. Betha, to please come forward to award a few students these great awards. Thank you. So when I call upon your name, please come forward. You'll sanitize your hands as you receive your award. So we'll start with the KRN September 2017 class. The best theory nurse. The best theory nurse is Amina Ahmed Ogle. Amina, please come forward. So congratulations, Amina. The best practical nurse in the same class, that's KRN September 2017 class, is Ruth Nairesiai Kanani. Congratulations, Ruth. I'm sure DNS is very happy to see you. Congratulations, Ruth. As Ruth is going down, then we have the best overall nurse in the same class. So this is a nurse who is all round, did very well in her theory, did very well also in her practical. And this is Amina Ahmed Ogle. All right, so KRN April 2018 class, the best theory nurse is Sylvia Wamboi Dithi. Sylvia. Sylvia, congratulations. Congratulations, Sylvia. In the same class, the best practical nurse is Lona Nyambura Masharia. Congratulations, Lona. So in that class, April 2018 KRN class, the best overall nurse is Sylvia Omboi Dithi. Well done, Sylvia. All right, so we go to the higher diploma programs, and we start with the critical care course. So here we have the best critical care nurse. So overall theory and practice, this is the best nurse. And the best critical care nurse is Yvonne Wamboi Kariuki. Congratulations, Yvonne. Well done, Yvonne. Well done. Well done. Then we have the Kenya Registered Neonatal Critical Care Nursing. These are the ones who nurse our babies. So the best neonatal critical care nurse is Joyce Chepkemoi. So Joyce, congratulations as you come forward. Well done, Joyce. The last Nairobi Hospital Award, sorry, not the last, the second last, is to the oncology nurses. So the best oncology nurse is Nicholas Mwenda Mguna. Nicholas. So as I had said earlier, this is the first group who joined the training in September 2020. Well done, Nicholas. Well done, Nicholas. So the last award in this category is the Leader of the Year. So this is the student who showed exemplary leadership skills as they led the other students. And the leader of the year is Nicholas Derek Okwako. All right. Thank you so much, Chief Guest. We may now take our seats. Thank you. So the next category of awards is by the National Nurses Association of Kenya, who have recognized the exemplary nurses. Chief Guest, the NNAK, as will be introduced, is an association for nurses. So they have awarded the best students. So for this, we'll start with the Registered Nurses Awards, and I'll invite Mr. Collins Ajwang. Please come forward. Mr. Collins Ajwang is the president or the national chairman of the National Nurses Association of Kenya, and he will give or award the best nurses. So the first award will go to the best overall nurse in the KRN September 2017. That is Amina Ahmed Ogle. So you have an NNK award. And I know you are a member. You were a member when you were a student. So please continue as a qualified nurse. So the next award is going to be awarded by the chairperson of the National Nurses Association of Kenya, Nairobi Hospital Branch, and that is Mrs. Margaret Muyuro. She will award this. Mrs. Muyuro, you're welcome. She will award, give this award to the best overall nurse in the KRN April 2018. That is Sylvia Waboidithi. So Sylvia, you may come forward. Thank you, Mrs. Muyuro, and well done, Sylvia. So the next category of award is by the Critical Care Nurses Chapter. The National Nurses Association of Kenya has a chapter called the Critical Care Nursing Chapter, and the Critical Care Nurses are members of that chapter. So this award will be given by our registrar, Mrs. Edna Talam. Mrs. Edna, karibu. And the awards will go to the best critical care nurse, that's Yvonne Waboi Karioki, and best neonatal critical care nurse, Joyce Chepkemoi. So you can come in that order. So Joyce Chepkemoi, you can come down. Thank you so much, Mrs. Kimayo, for giving us that opportunity and also for coming. So, Chief Guest, that will be the end of the award section. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Wambugu. Madam Chief Guest, please allow me to just tell our graduates one thing. Now, to whom much is given, much is required. So we require you, or we expect you, to act on the knowledge and skills that you've acquired during training. Some of you 3 years, and the specialty programs was 1 year. Now that is where your power lies. Okay? As graduates of the Cecily MacDonald College of Health Sciences, you will question,
you will teach and you will learn. Influencing processes to improve patients' outcomes and the patient experience. Now, the next session, Madam Chief Guest, is very special for every nurse, and I am a nurse, and I'm very proud to be a nurse today. It's the candle lighting ceremony. So, with a lit candle, it means that you will pass on the flame of hope, service, compassion, and peace. Allow me, Madam Chief Guest, to invite Mrs. Margaret Moyoro, who today is wearing a couple of hats. She's not only the NNAK Nairobi branch chairperson, she's also a board member of the Nursing Council of Kenya and the acting assistant director, nursing services in the Nairobi Hospital. Welcome, Mrs. Moyoro.
Thank you, Madam Kamamo. Our chief guest, Madam Lilian Nduzo, board chair represented by the vice chair, Honorable Vichage, our board member, Commissioner Philomen Musaka, the Nairobi Hospital CEO, Mr. James Nyamongo, our CEO Nursing Council, Madam Edna Talam, acting director of nursing services, Ms. Kola Kisia, acting principal, Cicely McDonald School of Health Sciences, Madam Joyce Betha, our distinguished guest, graduates now, parents, colleagues, fleds of nurses, all protocol observed. Good afternoon. It gives me great pleasure and I feel humbled to be before you to see how nursing in Nairobi Hospital have continued to expand. Every time Mrs. Joyce Betha, acting principal, we have seen the school expand, and when new nurses graduate, our role as Nursing National Association of Kenya is to welcome to the professional. We welcome you to the profession, and we are very expectant that you will show empathy to our patient, you display professionalism, and I would like to remind you again, you can serve in any point. Globally, you are recognized. A clap for that. I applaud you for the hard work, but without working smart, you may not achieve much. But I know with the values from the School of Nursing, you will be working smart nurses in every institution you will be working at. So, for the candle lighting, the essence of candle lighting, our chief guest, Madam Lilian Nduzo, is to initiate the new graduate in this noble of profession of nursing. This ceremony is auspicious for every nurse and is held in reverence of Florence Nightingale. Florence Nightingale is considered as the founder of modern nursing. In the Crimean War, Florence Nightingale walked with a lamp to the wounded soldiers. This gave them the warmth and it enhanced their recovery. As nurses, we light candle during graduation ceremony like this one. When we lose one of us, we do light a candle as a promise that we will carry on with the noble profession founded by the Nightingale. Lighting a candle for your colleague, for someone, it will not dim your light. But it means you will pass the flame of hope, service, compassion, and peace. To our graduate today, you made the right decision in joining nursing, especially this time of pandemic. All the family depended on the nursing profession, which is the backbone of any health institution globally. Well done. As we continue in nursing, I will encourage you to specialize. In Kenya, Nursing Council of Kenya, we have 11 specialty. We look forward to, as you progress, choose your passion. Specialize so that you can continue to give at your best. I congratulate you again in this auspicious occasion, and I welcome you to NNEK as a profession. I know you, when you are a student, you are members as student, co-associate members, but now you are full members. We'll be working with the committee which is here. I can see we are well represented by the vice chair and the secretary. They are here. We will recruit you. You join the professional body, and so that you can continue progressing in your career. At this juncture, it's my humble pleasure to invite our acting DNS, Madam Scholar Kisia. I also invite our CEO, Nursing Council, Madam Edna Talam. I also include our President, NNEK, Mr. Colin Ajuang, so that we can light the first candle. And kindly, beneath your seats, you can check whether you have a candle. Every nurse should have a candle so that we can light and then we can pledge that we will continue to give service to our people with all the dignity it deserves. Thank you, graduates, and congratulations.
Let us stand as we light our candles.
There is a candle in every soul, some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle, and makes his home. So carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the hopeless, confused and torn. Some other way. See now your sister, she's been robbed and lied to.
Silent.
I request everyone to stand, chief guests, kindly, so that as we support the nurses as they say their pledge. Thank you.
Okay, good afternoon. As we recite our pledge, kindly let us rethink the words that we are talking about. They are very deep, and let's internalize everything that we are saying as nurses. So I will begin, you will repeat after me, and where I will say I, you will mention your names, and then we continue as we go through this. So I will start. I, Scholar Kisia, solemnly pledge myself before God and the presence of this assembly. To observe the Nurses Code of Ethics and Conduct. I shall faithfully practice my profession in accordance to the laid down laws and regulations. As provided for in the Nurses Act, Cap 257 of the Laws of Kenya. I shall abstain from whatever is deleterious and mischievous. And I will not take or knowingly administer any harmful drug. I shall do all in my power to maintain and elevate the standard of my profession. And I will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping and family affairs. Coming to my knowledge in the practice of my calling. With loyalty, I shall endeavor to work with other team members in the provision of healthcare and devote myself to the welfare of those committed to my care. So help me God.
So help me God.
You can now put off your candles. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Just a reminder to our graduates once more that nurses are the hospitality of the hospital, for they dispense comfort, compassion, and caring, and for that they do not need a prescription. I will ask my co-MC, Mr. Obare, to just read for us a number of messages on our social media platform. Thank you.
Our chief guest, with your permission, allow me to read the following congratulatory messages. On our Facebook platform, we have Kipkoyo Tanui, who sends warm congratulations to Fancy. We have Roslyn Otiato, congratulations to all graduates, now the graduates. Ruth Ajema, congratulations to Emily Gero. And then Anton Kanja, congratulations to my sister, small sister, Diana Kanza. On YouTube, we have Penina Mumo, who sends congratulations to Wycliffe Nyambane. We have Fidelis Mbinga, congratulations to Joyce Kuvuna. We have Tom Ouma, all the way from Lancaster, Pennsylvania. Congratulations to Valerie. Luz Waitaka, who is a member of staff. Congratulations to the College of Health Sciences staff. I know you are up to task, and we look forward to more of the graduate. Duncan Mabeya, congratulations to my brother, Caleb Nyausi. I'm proud of you. Then now we have Agnes Lembaka. Congratulations to Ruth Kanani. We have Sophia J. Gray, mom to Patricia Masakari. Congratulations. There's also special mention of Machuki Nyamwaya Edwin. Congratulations on your graduation. And lastly, to Salesio Nyaga Mwaniki. I know it's been a long journey. Congratulations. Online learning was not easy, but we are happy you made it. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Mr. Obare. Madam Chief Guest, ladies and gentlemen, now it's my pleasure to invite the Kenya Registered Oncology Nurse, Nicholas Mwenda, to present the valedictorian speech.
Thank you for the opportunity. The chief guest, Madam Lillian Dozo, National Director for Division Kenya, Vice Chair of the Board Members of the Kenya Hospital Association, Honorable Dr. Chris Pichange, and other board members present, the Chief Executive Officer, Mr. James Nyamongo, Medical Advisory Committee, Medical Advisory Committee members present, other protocols observed, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. A pleasant afternoon to you all. My name is Nicholas Mwenda, class representative for the oncology class of 2021. It is an utmost honor to stand before you this day, delivering this valedictorian speech. I begin by thanking the Almighty God, as this journey wasn't easy. But by His grace, we get to witness this day. Coming in a strong second are our parents, guardians, and sponsors who have sacrificed immensely to invest in our education. Special thanks goes to HAMREF, Johnson & Johnson, for offering scholarship to oncology class and looking forward for future consideration in case of any other opportunities. We humbly request you continue offering sponsorship to other students. Second, I'd like to recognize the Leading for Education in Africa partnership, that is LEAP, for offering education loans which are affordable and easily accessible. To the Cicely McDonnell and lecturers, we cannot thank you enough because you have worked with us through this tough journey, offering mentorship, coaching, molding, and offering knowledge and skills to be who we are today. This was after some of us felt so overwhelmed and wanted to quit, but you gave a shoulder to lean on and gave maximum support to get the best nurses internationally. As you all know, a diamond must pass through fire. I would like to congratulate all the graduates for this milestone. As Nelson Mandela said, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. And today we celebrate being victors to this statement. We, the post-basic graduates, we began the journey a year ago, And for the Kenya registered nurses, this was 3 years ago, very green to the field, which was interrupted by the COVID-19 pandemic. Given that we started, or some of us continued this journey right in the middle of pandemic and succeeded, we are not only strong, but we are also heroes in our merits. As you can see, today's theme is training in uncertain times. We cannot forget to thank the Board of Management of the Nairobi Hospital that facilitated and subsidized expenses incurred this far. We thank you for giving us a safe environment for study during this ongoing pandemic and in dedicating time and patience all through the training. Thank you. I thank the Director of Nursing Services and all the clinical staff who took us under their wing to ensure our learning in the clinical area was impeccable. We thank you for holding our hands and getting some of us out of those loose rooms when we felt terrified of the reality of the clinical area. Thank you for the fine tuning. To the supporting staff, we cannot express our gratitude enough. The catering department, to whom we surrendered the sole duty of our nourishment. The home warden, with the eagle eye, who kept us on check. The cleaning staff, who ensured we were in a clean environment throughout. Thank you for the conducive environment that allowed us to strive for the sole purpose that got us here. To my fellow graduates, ours seems like something out of comic book. The long nights to when our lecturers would wonder what inspired the completed assignments on time, while to be honest, it was the due date. The butterflies on our assessments and examination days built in us the confidence we boast of today. Not forgetting at most suffocating in our masks as we rushed in the wards, learning how to offer quality care to the patients. We are caught up in our emotions as we are torn between the nervous excitement of our future and the joy of our memories. All in all, we have been equipped with more than just the skill required to become nurses. We have grown in wisdom and character. We depart this all today as individuals that desire in impact knowledge, gain more experience, learn from our preceptors and mentors in the clinical area. We recognize our very important role of responsibility towards the students left behind. We stood on very firm shoulders to get where we are today, and we will offer our shoulders for them to stand on. Let us not forget that education never stops. We learn every day. So, this is a stepping stone and not the final destination. I close this speech in the words of the Lady of a Lamp, that is the founder of modern nursing, Florence Nightingale, and a high quote. So, never lose an opportunity of adding a practical beginning, however small it is, for it is a wonderful how often in such matters the master and the sins germinates and roots itself. Thank you, Lux Interrebris. God bless you all.
Thank you, Nurse Nicholas, for that wonderful speech. Our chief guest, at this point in time, I want to address you. We looked at our world vision, and we realized that your mission is all about nurturing people, especially the ones from low-resource settings, for them to achieve their futures. which resonates very well with our mission. That is to mold our students from novice to professional level. At the end of it all, we have special members of our family who can be able to do that one very well, and that is the mothers. They are the ones who strive to ensure that children are well nurtured, supported, and taken care of in order to foster high quality lives that are, at the end of it all, ensure that families are transformed into the best way possible through motivation, inspiration for a better and brighter future for their families, communities, and nations. We as the Nairobi Hospital, we really want to take this opportunity to appreciate you for accepting to grace our graduation, and we have a small gift in appreciation for that. And our small gift is all about a mother who takes care of a child. At this point in time, I want to call upon our student nurse, Tabitha. Sorry for that. At this point in time, I want to invite our student nurse, Tabitha Munoru, to present the gift to our chief guest.
Thank you very much, Madam Chief Guest and all our guests and the graduates. We are almost at the end of our celebration today, and the next session is a couple of photos, and I will explain how we shall do this. So we request kindly that our Chief Guest and all the guests on the podium will come and stand up here, and then as I call each class, they will come and arrange themselves very quickly in the front at the right moment with a cue from the photographer. You remove your mask like for briefly. Yes? We take the photo and then we resume our COVID-19 protocols, right? Yes. So please, Madam Chief Guest and our guests at the podium, kindly come. We shall have the September 2017 class and the class lecturer, please, to come and organize themselves up here so we have a nice photo. Kindly. Yes, my chief registrar and also Mrs. Margaret Moyoro, please come up, and all SMT members present, kindly, please, I can see the director of strategy. kindly, please come and come up to the podium so that we can have the photograph, please. So now, thank you very much. April 2018 class, and their class lecturer, please.
Thank you. Kindly use the middle steps to go back up. As I request the critical care nurses and their class lecturer, kindly come down for the photograph. That our guests remain. They could just stay a little bit, we're about to finish. Through the middle. I'm going to request the Kenya Registered Oncology Nurses to come up front, and I'm also requesting our team from AMREF, please, and Johnson's and Johnson's to kindly come and join the class photograph plus the class lecturers for oncology. Tafadhali, we really appreciate you. Come.
Congratulations to our sponsors, Johnson & Johnson, AMREF International. Congratulations to Mr. Mlandi for steering the first oncology class.
Have the Kenya Registered Neonatal Critical Care Nurses and their lecturer please come down for the photograph. Thank you very much. Faculty members and the administrative staff, Cicely McDonald College of Health Sciences. The next photograph, please. Mr. Ngen, you're part of the faculty. I can see faculty members up there. Please come down. This is our moment. Thank you. I'm kindly requesting the clinical teaching team comprising of the acting assistant director of nursing services, the unit managers, church nurses present, team leaders, nurse preceptors. We really value you. Without you, we would not be able to have this graduation. Please come. We recognize what you do for the nurses in the clinical area. Please come. Unit managers, you can see them. I start mentioning their names in case they've forgotten. Yes, please. You're doing a good job. We recognize you. Thank you very much. It's my humble request, please, that Madam Chief Guest, please, accompanied by the Nursing Council of Kenya Registrar, we are requesting that you please, you sit those spaces. We want a good photo with the whole group. Eh? So kindly, our Chief Guest, Registrar Nursing Council, President of the Nursing Association of Kenya, our Acting GNS, please, and the Acting Principal, Mrs. Mbetha. We'll break the protocols for like half a second. We just, yeah. Then we have a photo with the whole group. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief Guest, and our invited guests for giving us the opportunity to keep the cherished memories for the 27th graduation. At this point in time, I have a few announcements, but before I do the announcements, we have one or two congratulations messages, and I'd like to share the same. One is from Church Nurse Maslini Belesia to Bibiana Shivoka. Congratulations. Catherine Akenyi to Sarah Otieno. We are so proud of you. Christine Muli to Lynn Mulewa, congratulations. Samuel Muregi to Tabi Murage, congratulations. And lastly, Winnie Kimani to Anne Kimani, congratulations. So these are the announcements. One, for those of us who came with cars, we're having a parking validation at room one. There's a security officer who is waiting to help you in a validation of the same. And then, this is the order in which you're going to leave. The room. First, the chief guest and those on the podium, followed by the all invited guests, SMT, church nurses, HODs, and then the faculty. Lastly, we're going to have the graduates, starting with the Kenya Registered Nursing, followed by the Kenya Registered Critical Care, Kenya Registered Oncology, and then Kenya Registered Neonatal Nursing. Our able ushers will be able to guide you. At this point in time, we are at the end of this ceremony, and we want to acknowledge that all good gifts come from God, and I will now invite our chaplain, Reverend Father Kabito, for the closing prayer. Thank you for your cooperation, and I wish you a blessed evening.
God is good. God is good. There is a reason why we want to say thanks to God. Our guest of honor and all the protocol observed. As we come towards the end of our celebration, I hope everybody is happy. And I want to leave this one to you as we get out of that door to reflect upon it. It's not my speech, but it's a speech that is written by the inspired word of God. When we read Psalm 126, it tells us this. When the Lord brought us back to Jerusalem, it was like a dream. How we laughed, how we sang for joy. Then the other nations said about us, the Lord did great things for them. Indeed, he did great things for us. How happy we are. Lord, make us prosperous again. Just as the rain brings water back to dry river beds. Let those who wept as they planted their crops gather the harvest with joy. Those who wept as they went out carrying the seed will come back singing for joy as they bring in the harvest. What we have done today is not a dream. What we are called to go out to do is to touch the life of people. It's not the life of animal or plants, but the life of people. You are the ambassador of our college. You are the ambassador of our hospital. You are the ambassador of Christ. Whatever you do is not for you, but you are commissioned by Jesus Christ himself to touch the sick and give them hope. Let us have hope ourselves so that we can be able to extend that hope to the needy in the society. The speakers of the day have encouraged us a lot. Let us ask the grace of God. Every day you wake up, every day you rest, ask God to give you more. And what we are asking today, put more compassion in your heart than in your hand. I invite all of us, we stand and we pray. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, we come before you because you are good to us. Thank you for being with us since the beginning of this ceremony. Thank you for giving us the gift of wisdom and love, all that we have heard from our speakers. May you help us, Almighty Father, to sing in our hearts and to put in practice. We have chosen these, the few, among many. You have called them to be ambassadors of giving hope to humanity. Jesus Christ, you called the disciples and you commissioned them. And you told them, I will be with you wherever you go. We commend our graduates today that wherever they go in this world to serve the life of human being, we ask the light that we have lightened in our midst to continue shining in the darkness of all the humanity in the world. Give them the wisdom they deserve. Give them the care they need. Provide them whatever they ask, Almighty Father. You call them and you created them in your own image. As they go to serve the humanity, when they are approached by many who need their services, give them the gift of love from their heart, to love what you have called them to do, and to exercise according to what they have been learning in school. Thank you for the gift of our guest of honor today. Thank you for the board of management. Thank you for the CEO, and thank you for the principal of our school, our college. Continue instilling them with the gift of wisdom, and whatever they do, Almighty Father, give them good health, protect them, and give them the light to continue showing the way for those who are coming in this facility to look for knowledge, to look for treatment, and all that they need. May your love prevail among us. As we get out of this door of this celebration, touch each and everybody and commission him to remind him or her what you have called him or her to do in the life of a human being. Shine your face upon each and everybody. Hold each everybody's hand or hand when we are so down, increase our faith. When we feel so much lonely, assure us the support of your holy people. Send the Holy Spirit to bring the unity and the love in this hospital, in our school, and whatever we do. And ask him only to God to bless you and to protect you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thanks a lot. Let's follow the order as we exit. Like I said, we are going to have the chief guest and those ones on the podium to leave first. Then all our invited guests, SMT, the church nurses, HOD, and then the faculty. Then lastly, we are going to have our graduates, starting with KRN, KRCSN, Care Oncology, and then Critical Neonatal Critical Care as the last group. Thank you. Okay, kindly, if you are awarded a gift, come to the podium so that you can pick it. Congratulations. Karen, it's your turn now. Kenya Registered Nursing, it's your turn. Our ushers will be able to guide you. We have a refreshment for you. Plus our current students, please don't go. We are very proud to have you around. We also have a refreshment for you. The oncology students, I'm informed that you're going to have a photo session in room 1 with the AMREF international team, the proud sponsors, that is inclusive of Johnson & Johnson. So oncology, Nicholas, kindly lead your team to room 1 for a photo session with the AMREF international and Johnson & Johnson. Mr. Wambu, congratulations for good work done. Ms. Gatari, congratulations for the good work done. Mr. Ayodi, we are so proud of you. Ms. Gitonga, I see you. We are so proud of you. Next time, I think we're going to have a special gift for you. Thank you. Jackson and IT team, we are so much indebted to what you guys have done. We are very proud. Kaka, tunashukuru sana. Kuna voucher ingine inakuja. Our fire marshals, thanks a lot. Our ushers, this is the way to go. Thank you.
to our able MC, Sarah SK Kamamo. Congratulations.